Alright, bonjour à tous, Battosay here, welcome to episode 14 of my Let's Play. And today we're gonna put the final touch into the breeding farm, and that's the part with the wheat farm. But before that, I'm gonna explain to you how to make your wheat farm. So I took the component of the wheat farm that I've built in the breeding farm, and I've placed them here, and I'm gonna try to explain them. So, first we have the detector for the growth, so that's going to be the clock for the timer. So to do that, I'm going to need two block detector, two block dispenser placed under the detector, and two pistons placed here. In the dispenser, I'm gonna place some seeds. Well, I'm gonna just place a couple. There we are. And I'm gonna place, let me just get rid of the flowers. I'm gonna place some redstone torch on the side of the detector. So I'm gonna grow some wheat to show you. The detector, place one block above the wheat, will detect when the wheat is fully grown, because it can see top of the wheat. So it turns the torch off, and we are going to use two wheat detector to make sure that we have a signal long enough to harvest all of the wheat that should have been planted. Yeah, let me get through all of the components maybe first. We have a first timer to detect when the wheat has grown. Then we have a monostable circuit to send a pulse. And then we need two timer. A first one to unleash the water. So let's suppose that the wheat farm, the most stone are the block dispensers, and the torches here are all of the wheat. We have a piston stopping some water. And when we unleash the water, the wheat will flow into your hopper or whatever. So we need a first timer to unleash the water and give it some time to make sure that all of the wheat will fall into our collection point. And then we need a second timer. When the first timer is finished, it stops the water again. But after that, you need to wait a little bit to use the dispenser to place some more seeds, because if you place them immediately after, there's still gonna be some water and your seeds are gonna be wasted because they'll be washed away by the water. So we need a second timer to wait until all the water is gone, and then this second signal goes to the dispenser to plant some more wheat. So that's the detector for the growth. That's the timer for the water, the blue one. It goes to the piston, and the second one is the timer for the dispenser to place the wheat once the water is gone. So back to the detector for the wheat. When both of the wheat here have grown, the signal here will be turned off. So this torch will turn on, so that makes it an AND gate. We want both of the signal to be on to send a signal. And when I do that, the torch here turns on. So after that, we have a monostable circuit that to have only a small pulse, like if it was a button. And this pulse will go into a flip-flop made with a block dispenser. You can use different things, such as a knowledge if you're familiar with redstone, but I've used a flip-flop with the block dispenser because that's the most compact things I could do in the farm up there. So the signal from the monostable circuit, which is like a signal from a button, so that's a short pulse, goes to the torch, which is here, and make the block dispenser change the block in front of it. So now that's a full block, a block of wool, and the other possibility is an axle. When that's the blue wool that's in front of it, since there's a torch under it, it's gonna send the signal to a gearbox. The gearbox is powering a turntable on the force setting, so the body block on top of it will make a full rotation in 20 seconds. When the width here has grown, it's gonna send a signal to this first flip-flop, turning it off. So the signal here is off, and it will go to the piston to unleash the water. That's the timer for the water harvest. Obviously, you wouldn't do it like that. On the farm, I've placed water above and unleash the water from above to be able to place more wheat, but that's just to show you. And the signal from the for the piston is the same that for the turntable here. So when the body block that's on top will make a full rotation, it will send a signal that will go into this block here, which will power the block under it. Oops, let's place it back. And this will power the torch and make it switch the block that in front of it. Let's just wait for that. The body block will power the repeater, which power the dispenser, and the block swapped. And now the turntable is unpowered again, so the body block stays in this position and the water stop. So let's watch this just one more time. If I send a pulse, looks like the block didn't update. Yep. If I send a pulse, the water unleash for 20 seconds, the body block starts rotating until it gets in front of the repeater, and then it's gonna change the block here and the water will move because the piston will be powered again. So that's the same signal for the piston blocking the water than for the gearbox on the turntable. Now we need a second timer, so the same signal from the turntable will go to this block to the first flip-flop, but also to the second flip-flop on the green wool here, which is made of the same thing. But we are gonna do that just now. The turntable with a gearbox powering it and a redstone torch here. So we are gonna just place a dispenser just here. I can actually place the redstone on top of it if I aim to the torch. And I'm gonna place two blocks, one conductive and one that's not conductive. So a non-opaque block and a full block. You can use anything like a panel, a siding, stairs, anything that's not full, like glass, so you can see through. And let's power it again. And we are gonna connect the signal from the dispenser here, the flip-flop, to the gearbox just here, and we are gonna send this signal to all of the dispenser. The body block made a full turn on the turntable and also sent a signal to the flip-flop. So the flip-flop is the flip-flop is just the torch, the block dispenser, and the torch under the wool block here. The flip-flop can be toggled with the signal from the body block here when it's fully rotates. Go from here with a repeater to make sure that the signal from the second body block won't switch the state of the first flip-flop. And so the final process is wheat grows, sends its signal to the water timer, let's call it, that's waiting for the water to get all of the wheat. Whoopsie, to get all of the wheat. Then when it's finished, it sends a pulse that stops the water and starts the timer that waits for the water to go away to send a signal to the block dispenser. So let's connect it. There we go. And let's see it in action. So when both of the wheat would have grown here, both of the torch turn off, it sends a signal to our first flip-flop, which allows the body block on the turntable to make a turn. After 20 seconds, the signal goes to the flip-flop again, and the water goes away, and the second timer starts spinning, and we'll send the signal to the flip-flop, which will plant the wheat. And your farm is ready to start again, except for the timer part, which, as you can see, is not connected yet. So the dispenser here has to be connected to the same signal as the block dispenser for the farm. So you have to take the signal like, let's say, here. Of course, that's not the best solution, not compact at all. We are gonna get to the farm above, so I could show you how it is when it's more compact. So let's just bring it down there. There we go. And the pistons are here, because if you simply use the block dispenser to also remove the wheat, the problem you'll get is that the wheat end up in the block dispenser, so the next time you try to pour it, it's placing seeds, but the time after that, it can pick up the small ones. If you make it make a more cycle, it will try to spit out the wheat. And your farm will be blocked because nothing will grow and it will stay stuck like that. So to prevent that, we are gonna remove the wheat before the dispenser tries to swallow them. And to do that, we are gonna remove them when the water is unleashed. So using the blue signal, the signal for the water to the pistons. So same thing, let's bring it up. Hopla, let's make it one block. Oh, come on. One block higher. There we go. And go all the way to the pistons. I just want the reversed signal, so I'm gonna use a redstone torch here, and there we go. And now when the wheat is fully grown, the signal from the water should also activate the pistons. To remove the wheat, as long as the water is here, and then when it sends the signal, the pistons will retract. And then again, 20 seconds later, when the second timer will be finished, still one more, the dispensers will place a new seed. and the start and the cycle will be able to start all over again. So let's quickly get back up so I can show you how I've compacted it. And yep, let's use the rope all the way up. And there we go. So the growth timer is exactly the same with the torch on the side, making an end gate that goes to this torch. Then we have the monostable circuits here that goes to the pistons above. The signal is here, powers the repeater, which powers the block, which powers these two redstone wire here. And then the signal, oh, glitchy delay, thank you. Then the signal goes into a torch, which you can see, it's just over here, that powers the first flip-flop, which, I can't even show you, which powers the first flip-flop with the buddy block for the timer. Then it sends, that's the signal to the water above, we'll say after, to harvest it. Then we have a signal to the second flip-flop, again with a full block, the red wool and a wooden slab. That sends the signal to the second turntable with the body block. And when it's over, it sends the signal to this torch, which powers all of the dispensers that are just above. To power all of the dispenser, I have two torches, this one just right here and one on the block above, and I just removed the first rows of torches to show you, so you can see that it's alternatively a repeater or a redstone wire, and I just need to add one set of block here. Like so, with the torch above. There we go. And then take the signal, that's the signal for the dispenser, which are here, that goes to the dispenser for the clock, and that also goes to the dispenser on the second part of the farm. And here I don't want the redstone to connect, so I'm just gonna place some block some blocks above. There we go. I can't place a block here because it's gonna block this block, so I'm just gonna make it go one block higher here. It should work. Yep. And this way all of the dispenser from the farm are connected. Let's get back up quickly. And there we go. We have all of our dispenser being powered from under them with a redstone torch. And we have a second torch under it. Of course, they're lower now because I haven't placed the seeds. And I fell through the hopper. Great. And that's how it is with the light blocks when it's set up. We have also... can I get up there with the rope? Yep. And to place the water to harvest the wheat, obviously, I've used the same trick with the same trick with the block dispenser, placing pistons. So I have four water sources over the piston head and over the piston body, just like on the other side. We have the block dispenser here, placing pistons. And when they remove the pistons, then the four water sources fall. And this way I can split relatively equitably the wheat into four different hoppers. The water. Let's see. I'm gonna make it grow quickly. There you go. I'm gonna do the same in the redstone timer. Just down there. First arc turned on, then the second. The piston removed the wheat, and we have the water which is unleashed above here. You'll have to place the blocks on the side. Oh, looks like I still have some wheat that ends up here. Damn, that's. And then water wash out, and the signal for the dispenser will come in to make it place some new wheat. There we go. So I still have to place one block here and a full block here and here, and looks like I'm gonna waste some wheat every now and then. And then the seeds fall in the hopper, since there's a wicker as filter to get the seeds all the way down, and the wheat fall in the water flow, which goes to the wheat dispensers for the breeding farm. So yeah, that's pretty much it. I hope it was understandable enough, and that you got how it works. And if you don't worry, I'm gonna make the tutorial on that on the Farming is Fun series about the wheat farm, probably after the holidays. But now I'm gonna do something else. I've started working a bit on the automated kiln because I want some easier and more automated ways to make solderns for the block dispensers to start the farms in the mansion. So that's gonna be the place with the setups. I've decided to make something not too complicated, so I'm gonna have an automated part to make the unfired pottery, and on the other side an automated part just to cook it, and the two won't be connected, but that doesn't matter much. I've made too much automated kiln, and I don't really feel like working on something too complicated. So we're gonna try to keep it simple. So the trick I'm gonna use to remove the pottery once it's cooked from the kiln, I'm gonna use pistons. So let's say we have some cooked pottery here. I'm gonna use two pistons to push block in the hole of the kiln. This one pushes two block, that's a regular piston. Just pushing the two block in here. And this one is a sticky piston, which pushes these two battle blocks back in their position, and then drag back this one here. And this makes the item which are inside all fall. So you can see I only have one. They all fall in the hole in front of them, and then I'm gonna just simply use a water flow that will go into a hopper with a chest under it. I'm gonna have two of them, one on each side, and I'm still trying to figure out which system I'm gonna use to carry the pottery above, because this block here, this one, will be a block dispenser. Well, I still have one, I can place it. Will be a block dispenser, and there's gonna be a hopper above it. And I'm gonna use some system, I'm not sure which one, to bring the items from here. I'm just gonna throw the pottery here and the items will go up and fall into a hopper, which will place the unfired pottery in the dispenser and then just make them cook and fall automatically over time. So I'm just gonna need a timer that will activate the piston once it's cooked, and slightly after place the block with the block dispenser. So just like if I do, well, yeah, we'll see. And yeah, set up to carry the items upwards to place them in the dispenser without having to have a direct access to the dispenser itself, because I'm gonna have water flows and probably a glass wall in front of it. So yeah, that's what I'm about to work on, and also trying to use something different to make the four kind of pottery. So I want to play a bit with this idea I got, using four turntable and a block dispenser, placing clay blocks. I think I have some over there. Placing clay blocks, yep, great. And then a piston, pushing it, a block dispenser, placing a new one, and using the four turntable. If I only, let's say, power one, I want to only make, what's the first one already? Yeah, crucible. So let's say I have, let's do that like that with, yeah, just quickly placing the setup to show you. Why is this powered? Oh, damn, yeah. There we go. With a lever, please. Do I have a lever? Nope. Let's get that on the chest. Yeah, great. So, let's say I power just the first turntable. Why isn't it being powered? There we go. That's weird. Let's see. Well, my idea was to make it only make one kind of pottery on one side, then be pushed and powered, make either crucible, vases, urns, or whatever. So let's say if, turn that off, if I just have the first turntable that is powered, when the block dispenser will place the clay block, it will make a crucible, then the piston will push it, and this one won't be powered, so it will stay like that until it reaches this gap in which there's going to be water, so the crucible will fall into the water and I can collect it this way. And if I have two turntables powered this way, I'll make a crucible on the first, then a vase, a planter on the second, then still a planter because this won't be powered, and I'll end up with vase. And if I want a planter, and if I want to make solarons, then I'll power the four of them, make them stay always 8 rotations on one turntable so that they become the next kind of pottery, and then they fall into the water. So yeah, that's the plan for this. That's what I'm gonna work on today. So yeah, still trying to figure out which timer I need for both of the setups, and what I'm gonna place in the middle. I was thinking just some cauldrons and crucibles. Yeah, that would be good. Yeah, I'm gonna place my cauldrons here. So, yeah, that's the plan today. I'm gonna work a bit on that and we'll get back soon. Damn, we're already at half an hour. I didn't even realize that. So, I guess we're gonna conclude the episode here, and that's gonna be the plan for the next one. We'll get to see the progress of the automated kiln. So this video will probably air after Christmas. So I wish you all happy holidays and hope you guys get lucky if you're having presents, and if you don't, well, just I hope that you have a nice dinner and have a nice time. And yeah, that's it for today. So I don't know why I'm doing this. That's it for today. I hope you enjoyed the video, and I'll see you soon. Bye bye, guys.